I've been always fascinated by how maps can change the way we look at the world. One day I thought, what if borders weren't drawn by politics or wars, but by nature itself? What if every river basin was its own country? To try it out, I gathered data from hydrosheds, FAO and World Bank sources, and built a global map where each river basin became a state. Then I added layers climate, population, population density, and economic data. Some basins would cover large territories, while others would be much smaller, almost like city-states. The climates would range widely, from tropical basins with year-round rains to Arctic watersheds locked in ice. Some would be among the wettest places on Earth, while others would struggle with long droughts. Basins like the Ganges, Yangtze or Nile would be home to hundreds of millions of people, dense and crowded. Others, such as the Yukon or the Lena, would remain nearly empty. And when you look at economics, the map changes again. Basins like the Rhine or the Mississippi would be among the wealthiest, while many others would lag behind. I don't think the world will ever actually redraw borders along rivers. Large basin states with bigger populations would likely conquer neighboring basins, especially in flat lowland regions where watersheds aren't much of a barrier. That's why I see this imaginary map more as a thought experiment. If every river basin was its own state, each one would have no choice but to manage its resources more carefully. Cut down too many trees, and flooding or erosion would harm your own land. Pollute the river, and your own people would suffer first. With no one else to push the cost onto, decisions would become more rational. And then there is competition. If the number of states increased dramatically, so would Jared Diamond in his book Guns, Germs and Steel, gives an example of why Europe, not China, surged ahead in navigation. In China, after a disastrous naval expedition, the emperor banned large ships for nearly a century. In Europe, no single ruler could stop progress everywhere. Even if one country restricted ships, neighbors kept building them, forcing others to follow. It wasn't just shipbuilding. Think of gunpowder, paper, and the compass, all invented in China. In Europe, the rivalry between states helped this invention spread faster, get refined, and eventually transform the world. In the end, this map is imaginary, but rivers for themselves are not. They cross our borders, sustain our cities, and remind us that water connects more than it divides. Thinking in terms of basins helps us see the world differently, not just as political lines, but as living systems we all depend on.